Hello guys, it's Sunil Digi here, and today we are going to see about the Samsung Galaxy A50 mobile, and let's start with its detailed specifications. So it has a 6.4 inch gorgeous Super AMOLED display with Full HD Plus resolution, and this for the price tag of 20,000 rupees, I think Samsung is the only brand that gives AMOLED display below 20,000 rupees, like M30, A30, and this here is a A50. So really great Samsung. So now let's see about the cameras also. The camera is also a real big gimmick in this phone for the price tag. So we got a 25 megapixel aperture 1.7 sensor, it's a main camera, and other two additional cameras have aperture 2.2, one is 5 megapixel, it's a depth sensor, and here we have a wide angle sensor which has 123 degree view angle, really great. And the front we get is a 25 megapixel aperture 2.0, and front and back we got a 25 megapixel sensor for high resolution photos, and they are true 25 megapixel sensors, not like the 48 megapixel sensor which has effective of 12 megapixel. They are true 25 megapixel sensors, but I think they are not effective. And let's see about the processor now. We got here is Exynos 9610 processor here, and this processor is really great. It can be compatible with both Snapdragon 660 and Snapdragon 675. It's a 10 nanometer process build, and I'm really happy to have such a good average performing smartphone, because this phone has just in a budget segment, they give an AMOLED panel everything, and they can't go just give the Snapdragon 675 because that's crossing their pricing limit or something. But if they did provide Snapdragon 675, the gaming would have been better. But actually 9610 also does provide a really great experience with the One UI they have provided. So let's talk about it later. And here we have is a RAM, is 4GB variant, it's a 19,900 rupees, and there's also a 6GB variant for 22,000 rupees. So if you want to check that, you can also check that one. And also we have is a stock storage of 64GB, and you can expand the storage up to 400GB beyond your limit. So, and also we have is a battery, is a 4000 milliampere battery which can easily stay up to 1.5 to 2 days. But if you are doing extensive gaming, then actually you can get only 1 day of usage. You can't go beyond that because this phone can't give much support in much efficient in gaming, because the processor is even 10 nanometer build. There's some issues with gaming. The battery life is just droning like that. So now let's see about the design. Actually you get a good design of polycarbonate plastic here, it's just plastic, not a glass, but still the premium look is really great. But I can't feel the premium in my hands like what I felt with my Samsung Galaxy A8 Plus, the glass build at the back. But still I think the polycarbonate plastic is good because they doesn't break, like they just don't break that much easily if you put the smartphone downwards or if you just drop the smartphone from any heights. But the display can't be guaranteed, but actually this plastic can't break into pieces like what this glass can do. So I did love plastic for that safety purpose, but still the premium enhance is not much good with this phone as the polycarbonate plastic. And also they can get scratches much easier than the glass on the 8 Plus and Note 8 or S8 or any phones. So now let's see about the basic thing. Like we got a USB-C port here, which is really nice. Not about this price range, but still Samsung does provide USB Type-C for the M series. Like their M10 is priced below 10K, but they have USB Type-C. And also we have here, like last year in A7, or J8, they didn't provide a micro USB, they did provide a USB Type-C with headphone jack, really nice Samsung. So we got also the speaker grill and the primary microphone here, and also a secondary noise cancellation microphone here. So the speaker is really great. Now sound problem is not an issue now, because after an update I got the speakers really sound really nice in the earlier version. So now let's see about the One UI of the smartphone. This has a really great user interface. This is an Android 9 build, a One UI of Samsung, and I think almost every flagship smartphones of Samsung like S8, S9 and S10 has the One UI opportunity. Even S8 will get the update soon for One UI, and I'm really happy with this UI. Actually it's really smooth and it's really handy. It's really great to use. I feel really premium for the UI actually. So you can also expect Android Q updates. When the Android Q launched, after around 3 months or 4 months, you may also get Android Q for this phone, and also another version you can expect. So no issues with the update also. Samsung is providing it perfectly. And now let's see about the sound quality of this phone. Actually, the sound quality over headphones is supported by Dolby Atmos optimization. Really great. I love the Dolby Atmos. Even I have a Dolby Atmos home theater setup in my hall, and feeling them with the headphones is also really great. So I did love with this Dolby Atmos optimization they provide. And also the sound over the earpiece and the speaker over here is really great. Not like the earlier. First of all, when I bought this phone, I felt most of the issues in the both of these speakers. But after an update, I feel really better with the speakers and something else. I'm really loved to use that. So the navigation keys is also optimized with the Android 9's gestures. So I'm really happy with that also. So finally, I have to tell you one thing. So these features we were seeing was not a big con, and they are really a best one to be considered. But when I just going to say one thing is, this phone is not coming up with an proximity sensor and an ambient light sensor. It's really very, very devastating. But for the design they actually provide, I think they can't put those stuff. But OnePlus did. Chinese brands are doing bringing IR sensors with the proximity sensors and also virtual ambient light sensors. Sorry, ambient light sensors, which is physically in the smartphone's hardware. But Samsung does provide here's a virtual proximity and virtual ambient light sensor. Really not much great. And all these both virtual will work with the front-facing camera, which is not battery efficient, and also which is not an accurate point of view. So that's the only con I feel in this smartphone. Even when you talk to someone, you just place your phone onto their ear, the display will turn off after 2 seconds because it is not much accurate, and also killing the battery life. So this is the only thing I actually felt bad in this phone. But other things are really great. I love the smartphone. Even may you also will love when you buy this one. For the price tag of below 20,000 rupees, I think this is the best smartphone in the market. But if you are just aiming for cameras, I need a good cameras, I need a better camera, and I need a better performance, and you can go for the Redmi Note 7 Pro, because they provide a 48 megapixel IMX 586 sensor, really great. But also they provide a good battery life, like around 200 mAh higher than this phone, and still they provide you something like my UI and that interface. But if you really love Samsung and you want Samsung branding and you need Samsung's features, so you have to surely go for A50 for this price range, because this gives a really great performance and also great value for money with their AMOLED display and design. So only thing I feel was the virtual sensors on the top is not much good. So thanks for watching guys, please subscribe my channel for more videos and more stuff. And see you later. Bye.